I want to share very briefly today on the topic rejoice and be glad. The Lord comes. Rejoice and be glad. The Lord comes. In the Anglican Church, today being the fourth Sunday of Advent, in actual sense, it is the last Sunday of Advent, since this coming Friday will be Christmas Day, when we celebrate the coming and the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so when we began Advent Sundays from first Sunday, second, until today, fourth, we were looking forward to the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the coming of the Lord, brothers and sisters, is a new dawn for God's creation. For Christians, Christmas is a new break, it's a new dawn when God Himself leaves His throne in heaven and comes down to live with His creation. And so Christians, to us, this is a great time of God of all glory leaving His throne in heaven, visits humanity to live with humanity for salvation and restoration. And therefore, such a great work of grace that God does calls for rejoicing and being glad and for celebration. Of course, you'll be shocked, why talk of celebration when you can't see the smile on my face and I can't see the smile of your face because of COVID-19. Prophet Zechariah is one of the prophets who prophesied during Israel's captivity in Babylon, and especially the time when the exile was coming to an end. Friends, anything that has beginning must also have an end. Whether COVID-19 has disturbed us and changed life in 2020, one day by the grace of God, it will come to an end. And the Lord will bring restoration. And today I pray that may this message be prophetic upon the nation of Kenya and upon your life as an individual today. You who have mourned, you who have cried, you who may have lost everything so important to you, you who have felt that your life has gone back several steps when you would have been very far, may God's visitation upon your life bring a new dawn. Praise the name of the Lord. Therefore, the message of Zechariah is a message of joy. In the midst of pain, in the midst of confusion, in the midst of uncertainty, in the midst of not knowing whether businesses will open fully in 2021, whether schools will open fully in 2021, there is a call for rejoicing and a call for joy. It is a message of praises to the Most High God. The message of Zechariah is a message of restoration and a message of God's visitation of His people. Zechariah's message is a message of a new dawn in the community that has gone through suffering and oppression and shame. If there are people who are so proud, they were the Jews. If there are people who are so happy, prospered, they were the Jews. Why? Because of all the nations of the world, they were the only people of God who saw the miracles in Egypt, in the desert for 40 years, the crossing of the Red Sea, the crossing of River Jordan when it has overflowed its bound, the conquering of mighty nations, the Anakites, the Kittites, and all those Ites and Canaanites, and they possessed that land. Yet they lost it because of their COVID-19, which was the Babylonian captivity. So when Zechariah writes today to give them a message of celebration of joy, it might have been a shock to them. The Israelites in captivity are being told to shout and be glad, yet they are still in captivity. How can you shout and rejoice when you lost a job that was giving you $50,000 a month? How would you be called to shout and be glad when your business was giving you a turnover of $10,000 a week? It's all gone. Yet God still calls us to shout and rejoice, because the Babylonian captivity is finally coming to an end, and with the intervention by the Lord God Himself. Rejoice and be glad, the Lord comes. Why rejoice and be glad this time when we have gone through difficulties as a result of this pandemic? Why rejoice and be glad that there is not much to look up to or to expect this Christmas? I'm sure by this time, Nairobi will be like a ghost city, because families have gone to Mombasa. Families have gone to Zanzibar. And those who can fly have gone to Dubai and to Geneva. Why rejoice and be glad this Christmas when you're not sure whether we'll travel to the village for family gatherings? Three things. Number one, rejoice and be glad because God has chosen His dwelling among His people. Brothers and sisters, I may not have food on the table. I may not have good clothes. I may not travel out of Nairobi. But the presence of God upon my life makes the difference. And because of that, I will shout and rejoice. But take everything else, but leave me Jesus. Take everything else, but leave me with God. I will still have a smile. Because when I have God, I have Jehovah Jireh, the Lord who provides. Jehovah Rapha, the Lord who heals, the Lord who blesses, the Lord who dwells among us despite the needs. And when you have God, you have everything. It may not be seen there tangibly, but there is assurance that the Lord who owns 1,000 cattle, 1,000 hills, the Lord who owns all gold and silver has come to live with me. I can shout and rejoice. Praise the name of the Lord. Shout and be glad, O daughter of Zion, for I am coming, and I will live among you, declares the Lord Almighty. God encouraged the Israelites in the midst of their captivity to rejoice and be glad, for there is light at the end of the tunnel. It will be not dark forever. Weeping may remain for a night, but rejoicing comes in the morning. I declare this afternoon in the mighty name of Jesus, the child of God, you will smile again. Amen. You will dance again. Amen. You will rejoice again. Amen. You will jump up again. That the Lord of all restoration will restore to us all that the devourer has taken from us. It will be not dark forever, in Jesus' name. Amen. Even though the captivity had not abruptly come to an end, even though they were still feeling or experiencing the pains of captivity, God summons them to a celebration mood. Never confess that there's nothing to celebrate this Christmas. Celebrate the presence of God in your life. Amen. You have something to hang on. It is not just dark. God is summoning us and calling us to a celebration mood. The promised coming of the Lord should be a game changer in the life of a Christian. Why? Because joy and celebration are not dictated by the current situations. Child of God, your joy, your smile should not depend on your feelings, on what you have or you don't have. It should be Jesus Christ, the hope of glory in your life. That is the game changer. Let the enemy take whatever you may take that is tangible, but he can never take Christ, the hope of glory in your life. So our joy, our celebration, our shouting for joy, it is not that you have won a bet, or you're better than won, or your team won, or you got a pay rise, or you got that job. Your joy and celebration depends on Jesus Christ in your life. Praise the name of the Lord. Neither does our joy and celebration depend on our current locations. I know at this time people have moved home. People who stayed in Runga may have moved now to stay in Komaro. People who live either in Daiga have moved to their little house or building in Joska. It has not been the location. It means Jesus Christ in you. Never give up because you lost anything. Because you have relocated to Gishagi. That does not dictate our joy. It is the Lord Jesus Christ in our lives. I know our lives have been disorganized. Life has not been the same. For the first time we have had words abnormal and normal, which we never had in 2019. But it is okay. They will not take the joy of Christ in our hearts and the joy of salvation. Praise the name of the Lord. Our location, our current situation depends on God's purpose and God's will for our lives. Our current locations and circumstances should not be so much dictate our future, because God has the final say. Please don't write yourself off in 2020. God has the final say over your life.
Amen.
Nobody, your employer has no final say. They have given you the last check. They may have cut it. And as you see things, they may even cut it foul. But that does not dictate your joy. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
God has the final say. When God invades our circumstances, when God invades our locations, not only for a courtesy call, but to live among us. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
So never say God visited me. He does not visit you as a courtesy call. He comes to dwell. And please, if you have this plague in your house, that Jesus is the silent visitor at the times of meal, please go remove it. He is not a visitor. He has come to dwell. To dwell.
Amen.
To dwell means he is comfortable. He can move in the bedroom, move in the kitchen, move in the children's bedroom. He has come to dwell, to live. He is not a visitor. So sorry if your Christ was a visitor who visited you in 2019 and 2020 he went. I'm sorry for you. He is not. He has come to dwell. He does not make a courtesy call the way I visited you and I left. He has come to dwell. So he is with you. And never say he's unseen. He is seen. It's only who have refused to see him. So go remove those writings from your wall and see him guest at the times of meal. Again, it's only a guest at the time of meal. Very interesting. Hallelujah. So friend, this calls for celebration regardless of our current situations. The psalmist acknowledged the secret of God's choice to dwell with his people, and he pronounced in Psalm 113, verse 1 to 3, praise the Lord, praise all servants of the Lord, praise the name of the Lord. Let the name of the Lord be praised both now and forevermore. From the rising of the sun to the place where it sets, the name of the Lord is to be praised. Not on the time of meal. His name is to be praised at all times. Even when you are sick, even when you are in bed, even when you are hungry, the name of the Lord is to be praised at all times. Secondly, why rejoice and be glad? Because God's universal vision for all people. God's universal vision for all people. Friends, the coming of the Lord is not a preserve of the Jews only. But God has now chosen to reach out to all peoples of the world. The first day prayer, they said that the people of God, God belongs to them, other people are bad, but God is saying now there is a paradigm shift. Now I am coming to all peoples of the world. And Zechariah says, many nations will be joined with the Lord in that day and will become my people. Hallelujah. Regardless of the tribe, regardless of the color, regardless of the size, all have become God's people, a universal vision to all the world. So God is not only located in Israel. So when you live here, you are going to walk in Israel. That is just a location, but God is not there. God is also here. Even in Gatuli, where you come from, God is there. Hallelujah. Even Kirinyaga, where our brothers and sisters come from, God is there. He has become Lord of embrace everyone. So we no longer see you as Kelelele Tangatang. You are the people of God. And that's what Paul has been telling us, has been going the pastoral visitation. Paul had a big heart that in all my prayers for all of you, not some of you, for all of you, I always pray with joy. Universal unity, everybody fitting in Paul's heart, and everybody has a place in God's heart. Praise the name of the Lord. So God, this Christmas, God is not only coming to Bethlehem. And I wish we should stop all these singing songs of Christmas. Oh, Bethlehem, oh, Judea. Now let's also sing Bypass. Let's also sing Kahawes, Kiamumbi. Because even there, Christ comes. In that little place, Christ comes. In that dirty place, Christ comes. In those places I cannot pronounce where Christ comes. There is this place, lovely place here. I can't pronounce well. But in there, Christ comes. Those are his people. Whether they're in Chana, whether they're in war, they are his people. He's coming for everybody. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
He is not a tribalist God. He is a universal God of all people. The Lord does not only shift his residence from heaven above to come down and dwell among people, but his vision is also universal, including many nations. And this is my prayer in 2021. We are going to take the gospel to many nations. Please prepare. Because this God, we must share it even to that tribe that you hate so much. God loves them. Even those Muslims, God loves them. Even those Al-Shabaab, God loves them. And we must reach them with the love of Jesus Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. And thirdly, why rejoice and be glad? Because God has aroused himself into action. God has aroused himself. He has woken up into action. Friends, when we go through problems, we might be tempted to believe that God is aloof, that God is not seeing, that God is deaf, that God is blind. He is not interested in our affairs. However, Israel is being asked to be still before the Lord and all mankind, because God has woken up. God has decided. And when God is decided, the demons must flee. When God steps into the scene, every problem must align themselves to his will. Every enemy of God will flee. Praise the name of the Lord. He has aroused himself from his dwelling place. Where he sat on his throne, he has decided to wake up, and it is time for action. And you know one of the verses that blesses me in the Bible? Is it Acts chapter 7 or 9? That when Stephen was being stoned, he looked up and he saw Christ standing, not seated at the right hand side of God. Christ stood to be with Stephen as the stones flew on him, as they punished him, as they tormented him. Christ was not comfortable. He rose. Hallelujah. I want to encourage you. The pains, the struggles you have gone through, it is not Christ is seated comfortably at the right hand side of God. He has been standing together with you. But then not just standing, now he is stepping out from heaven to come and identify with you in your problem, in the struggle in your marriage, in the struggles in your business. He has decided to come, walk from heaven and come down. And so for me, Christmas, it is not what you have slaughtered. It is not the new dress. It is Christ who identified with me in my pain, in my struggle, in my disease, in my defeat. He comes and identifies with me. For me, that is Christmas. Leave alone all this traveling to go and celebrate and to eat and to what? To me, it is Christ who I've chosen to identify with my situation, with my pain. And sometimes we may just sit with him, not saying much. Sometimes just feeling his presence and that comfort and those tears coming out of my eye. His presence clothing me, overwhelming me. To me, even if I've not eaten chicken or anything, to me that is satisfying. Praise the name of the Lord. When we go through the problems, let us never judge God that is aloof, that is deaf, he has no feeling. I tell you good news today, he has chosen to step down. And I declare this afternoon, brothers and sisters, by February 2021, COVID will be a gone case. The Lord has chosen to step down in the name of Jesus Christ. And when he sits down, he cannot share his glory with any disease or any pandemic or any enemy of his. Praise the name of the Lord. But God is saying, be still. The battle now is his. You have struggled enough. You have shouted enough. You have quarreled enough. You tried to convince people enough. He is now saying, be still. The battle is taking over from you. The pain is taking it over from you. Be still. So this Christmas, as we talk of Christmas, the birth of Christ, be still. The Lord, before the Lord, no more struggling, because the Lord has aroused himself to take charge of all situations. Be still, let go, relax, and let the Lord take charge of every situation. Be still and do not worry, because he is sprung into action. In conclusion, brothers and sisters, rejoice and be glad the Lord comes. This Advent, as we anticipate the coming of Jesus Christ through his birth, may we rejoice, because Christmas is a paradigm shift. Can we now shift and forget about COVID-19? Because the Lord is saying, be still, it is my business. It is his job. It is his concern. It is now taking it over from us. So be still. And so your job is shout for joy. Shout and be glad. Celebrate him. First, God's residence has shifted to be among his people. Through Jesus Christ, God has become Emmanuel, God with us. God's presence with us in the midst of this COVID-19 pandemic should lead us to a celebration rather than mourning and whining. Secondly, God's relationship is no longer confined to the Jews or to specific people, to the Israelites, but it is extended to all peoples and all tribes of the world. And the Bible says, because of the birth of Christ, all people who live in darkness have seen a great light. Through Christmas, God's vision of salvation has been extended to all humanity. And thirdly, through Christmas, God has chosen to personally reach out to humanity and not waiting for humanity to reach out to Him. He aroused Himself, came out of His throne, not sending any angel anymore or any prophet anymore, but He Himself walking in that room where you stay, in that home where you stay, in that fire where you are. He has chosen to come and dwell with you.